Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade with another Coding Fundamentals in GML tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about data types. A data type is an attribute that tells the computer what type of data it's dealing with and how it can treat that data, what it can do with that data. And it's that second part that I think is the most important. For example, saying 5 times 5 makes sense. We understand that, we know what it would do. But saying John times John does not really make sense. We don't know how to do mathematical operations with John. Because we have a concept of numbers and what we can do with numbers, and we have a concept of words and what we can do with words, and we can do mathematical operations with numbers, but not really with words. So now let's talk about the types of data that GameMaker Studio 2 allows you to use. I'm going to run through all the different types in brief, and then I'm going to go through the 4 most common types again in greater detail. Starting with the most common types of data in GML, we have strings, which are text, real numbers, which are any numbers, booleans, which are true or false, and arrays, which are special. They are a special type of data that GameMaker Studio 2 has. Still fairly frequent, but less common, we have enums, which I'll have a whole tutorial on, and undefined. Undefined is essentially a dummy value that you get when GML needs to give you something, but they can't give you what you asked for. For example, when you look something up in a map, but that value doesn't exist. And if that doesn't make sense, don't worry about it. We'll cover data structures later, and we'll see some examples of undefined then. Finally, we have some fairly rare data types that you only ever use if you're doing some very specific things. I'm not going to cover them in depth, but they are none, not a number, infinity, hexadecimals, and pointers. You can find out more about data types by reading about them in the manual, which I would highly recommend. Okay, so now that we've gone through the types of data that GameMaker Studio 2 allows you to use, let's talk about the 4 most common types of data. These data types cover probably 99.9% of all the data types that you will use. And for each of them, we're going to cover what they are, how to create them, and give just a very general overview of what you can do with them. Let's start with strings. Strings are text. It can be a single letter, it can be a word, multiple words, it could be a paragraph, etc. There are several ways to create them. I'm only going to go over the main one here. We will have a separate tutorial on strings and some of the intricacies of them later on. But the primary way to create strings, the way that you'll use most of the time, is with double quotes, not single quotes, not smart quotes, just regular double quotes on both sides. Switching over to GameMaker Studio 2, you can see some examples right here. First name equals John, last name equals Doe, famous phrase, hello world. And you can see that the strings have changed color to red. Now the color you get may vary because you can set it up for yourself in preferences, but if you successfully create a string, it will turn that color. For example, now you'll see that this is a string, but now it doesn't know what to do with this. And there we have it starting a string again, but it doesn't end. And so it's giving us an error. So that's what strings are and how you create them. Let's switch over to what you can do with them. I'm going to bring up the manual here, and you can see a whole list of things that you can do with strings. I'm not going to go over them in depth. We don't have time for that, but I would recommend reading through this list and just seeing what's out there and seeing what you can do with strings. So next up, we have numbers. There we go. Numbers are any real number. They're also GameMaker Studio's default data type. You can see a quote here from the manual that basically just says, if it's not anything else, it's a number. If you're coming from another programming language, they're doubles or ints on some platforms. And on other platforms, just doubles. So it's safe, I think, to treat them always like doubles. If that doesn't make sense, don't worry about it. You create a number simply by typing a number. You can use numbers, the negative sign to make a number negative, or decimals. Switching over to GameMaker Studio 2, you can see some examples of numbers. So with numbers, you can do all the mathematical operations that you would expect. And again, GameMaker Studio has a bunch of built-in functions, which we're not going to cover here, but I would recommend reviewing. Next up, we have booleans. Booleans are a value that can be either true or false. To create a boolean, you just type the word true or false, lowercase. And you can see that they will change color. If I were to use a capital letter, for example, it will not recognize it as the Boolean value. So you would just want to use lowercase, true or false. It is important to note that GameMaker Studio currently interprets any real number equal to 0.5 or less as false and greater than that as true. However, you can't be sure that that will always be the case in the future. So best practice would be to use true and false when you want to use a Boolean value. Boolean values are very important. They're used with conditional statements and logical operations, and we'll have tutorials on both of those things later. So finally, we have arrays. Arrays are data that hold other types of data. You can think of it like a list, although GameMaker Studio 2 actually has something called the list, and I don't mean that. I just mean a normal list, like a grocery list or a to-do list. What makes arrays, though, different from the other types of data we've been talking about is that the array variable, or the variable that holds the array, is not actually the data, but a reference to that data itself. Arrays are very important. You use them all the time. They're one of the fundamental building blocks of code, and we're going to have a couple of tutorials at least on how to use them. Now, there are several ways to create arrays, but I'm going to cover the two most common here. Switching over to GameMaker Studio 2 again, you can see the first way here, array create. This is a built-in function. It allows you to create an array of a certain length, and if you want, specify the data that will be in every position. So you don't need that second argument. You can just use the first one, how long, but if you want, you can have that second argument, and then you will create an array where everything is zero, or everything is negative one, or everything is hello. The other way to create an array is with the array literal. You use brackets on either side and you separate each value with a comma. Now, I'm just using numbers here, but they don't have to be numbers. You can have any type of value that you want. You can even have arrays inside of arrays. Whoops, let me use the correct variable name. So arrays can hold arrays, or they can be arrays of arrays, and those arrays can hold arrays, so you can nest them just going on. I mean, there's a practical limit, but effectively forever. Because arrays are so fundamental, there's a lot you can do with them. And we're gonna have, like I said, several tutorials on them. But again, if you wanna know some of those things in advance, we've got the manual here. Just look up arrays. Okay. Now, before we conclude, let's run the debugger once and look at how GameMaker Studio 2 stores all of these variables. Okay, so let's step through the debugger. So we have strings. You can see them showing up down here as strings. They've still got the quotes. Now you can see all of the numbers. Now we have our Booleans, which GameMaker put here and here. One important thing to note for the Booleans is that they are still represented as numbers. False is 0, true is 1. And then finally, we have the arrays. Notice that the array is not the actual value, unlike these other variables. It is a reference to that array, and in the debugger, you can expand it and look at what is actually in that array. Okay, so in summary, data has a type. That type determines what you can do with that data. For example, find out how long a word is or how long a string is, do mathematical operations, and so on. And the four main types are strings, numbers, Booleans, and arrays. So we have some links here, and as always, the links to the slides, to the source code, and to everything else will be down below as well. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.